that it's not only the corporate. Yes, no, some of you may join corporate, but there's also corporate responsibility. If you were to be working in a Bhopal, you know, type of, you know, corporate, you would fight for the people. And then also, obviously, you think that the justice is somewhere, but concern for justice. And you have to define justice yourself. And standing for justice all through life is very important. I will add one more comment and stop. Dr. Bal Gopal, when he was interviewed by one of the journal, and they said that you work 24 hours, day and night. You travel, you sleep in bus stands and all that. In fact, once when we went for fact-finding, next day we were to meet a collector. That night, there was no light. He was in a toilet, in a bus stand. And he, all the night, he sat in the toilet and typed the fact-finding report to be ready for the next day morning. How does one do this? And then Bal Gopal said, only sense of justice is driving me into this direction. And that notion of justice somehow makes me to work so hard. So I think that that is, you know, extremely important, that we have some sense of justice. Society should be fair and just. You can't live in an unjust society. And you have a very important role to play in creating fair and just society. And people are working. There are people in India, fortunately, who stand and who fight for these things.
Thank you. Yeah, I mean, just I would like to add to what you were saying about there being different kinds of attempts at various levels. Yeah, quite often we find that, there needs to be more concerted kind of effort, you know, what you call coming together of these forces. Quite often our energies are also dissipated when different organizations struggle. On a lighter note, actually at one point when our friends were getting picked up left and right, we said instead of having a committee for the defense of Sai Baba, should we have a standing committee? We'll defend anyone who gets picked up. But at the same time, there is a need for localized committees also. So I don't think that one an umbrella like organization would need. So what we need is larger organizations which would fight for these rights, and localized, individualized kind of, because the context of each of these struggles may be different. So it's quite important to understand the people who are actually there, rather than, because quite often we go with, you know, different notions and perceptions. So that's why I think we cannot wish away this kind of multi-level struggles may be necessary. That's what I would.
I think in conclusion, it would be appropriate to say that regardless of what our political opinions are, where on the spectrum of political opinions we stand, we can all agree that, as Professor Ambastha was suggesting, it says a lot about the character of a democracy, how it treats dissent among its citizens. I would request the audience to only stay on for another 10 minutes, because two of our first year students would like to present some of their poetry for you. Archer will be singing a song that she wrote after a discussion that she had with Miss Vasanta. Aditya would also like to read out some of his poetry for you. So I would request you to hold on for another 10 minutes.
Friends, I would like to first let you know that I am starting my poetry. The premise of the poetry starts from this image, which is not opening on my laptop. So I bring my premise of the poem. There was an incident where the fingers of a 5 or 6 year old child were chopped off by the army men or the CRPF men, whatever you may call them, just because he belonged to a tribal area and he was considered to be a threat to the nation. Now, let me start. The poem is in Hindi, I apologize. So I've tried to make some translations. Dekho. Dekho, vah dekho kya hota hai. जंगल में खिले पलाश तले वह बच्चा क्यों रोता है वह देखो उसकी अंगुलियां किसने काटी है कौन वीर जिसने है इससे युद्ध किया देखो देखो एक लड़की भी लहू लुहान पड़ी है भारत की सेना का इसको पुरुषार्थ कहो 21 साल की थी उसकी गलती बस इतनी लड़की थी और जंगल में वह रहती थी है कौन जलाता झोपड़ियां बेमतलब में कहता है मर जाओ या बर्बाद रहो है पाप तुम्हारे तुम न बड़े घर में आए, पर चुप रहना यह लोकतंत्र है याद रखो। मैं लिखता था यह सब, सरकार को शायद पता चला, इस कलम बिचारी को परसों फांसी दे दी, अंतिम इच्छा पूछी उससे जल्लादों ने, दो कविताएं लिख गई वो मरते दम तक भी। ए जालिम मैं सब लिख दूंगा, क्या हुआ अगर मर गई कलम है, अब खून बहेगा मेरा कोई बात नहीं, ए जहां मेरी उंगली काटो कि खून बहे, मुंह बंद किया पर खून नहीं रुक पाएगा, सब लिख दूंगा इससे ही इन दीवारों पर। एक दिन आना पढ़ना सबको पढ़ने देना, सच जीतेगा मैं नहीं रहा तो क्या गम है, वह जीत का दिन होगा बस तुम देखो तो, फूल खिलेगा हर डाली पर आजादी का, हर बच्चा फिर से मुस्कान दिखाएगा, यह रात ढलेगी जुल्मत की दिन आएगा, यह रात ढलेगी जुल्मत की दिन आएगा। थैंक यू।
Will sing a song for us. It will just take another 3 minutes.
Even I do apologize since this song is in Hindi, but I have tried to make some translations, quote unquote. And on the basis of the simple fact that what Scoot Hamilton said once, that the only disability in life is bad attitude, and according to what professor said, definitely, Professor Sai Baba does not have a bad attitude. So, this song basically relates to detesting and dismissing the kind of brutalities people who are vulnerable are facing right now. So, here is it for you. चलो इन तकदीरों को बर्खास्त कर दें, दिल में दिया जला के नया दिया जला के एक दरखास्त कर दें, कितनी है हर एक आहट में, कुछ तो अब तू फितूर दे चाहत में, क्योंकि साहिर नहीं है अब सोहबत में, चलो इन तस्वीरों को बिगड़ती तकदीरों को
बर्खास्त कर दें, जख्म को मात देके यही जज्बात लेके एक दरखास्त कर दें।
Law and Society Committee, I would like to thank all of you for turning up. I would like to thank our panelists and everyone who helped us make this event possible. I would request the first year co-ops, Saurav and Girija, to give our panelists a token of our appreciation. Thank you.